Well, starting a business certainly isn't easy, but it was a cinch for a Folsom mom who saw a golden opportunity in her daughter's droopy drawers.
Why don't you show them a dance? Go ahead.
From the waist of a skinny child came a fat idea.
I came up with the idea of the attachable, adjustable waistband.
Eva Winger's slender daughters had droopy drawers until she created the Cinchies.
I'm going to peel it open like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to place it in the back center seam of the pants on the inside. You press it down on top of the existing waistband.
Peel and press, stretch and stay.
You press the waistband onto the fabric and it just sticks. No ironing, no sewing, nothing else is involved.
One of the keys to being a successful mompreneur is making sure that you don't grow too quickly. If your name gets out there and your demand starts to soar, you'd better make sure you have supply to meet it.
Eva makes most of the Cinchies right here in her living room. She's getting her name out by offering free samples in parents' magazines across the country.
I thought, you know what? I could probably give away 1,000 or 2,000 of these. It'd actually be cheaper to do it that way than to get a PR marketing firm, which I couldn't afford. I'm a mom, and if I got to try a product and I really liked it, I would tell all my friends about it.
She's had 2,000 requests in just 4 months.
Obviously, I would love to see financial rewards from this, but what's even more exciting is to see something that you've created and somebody writes in and is excited that it solves their problems.
Parenting is seldom a cinch, but keeping your kids' pants in place should be.
And Eva's joining us live this morning with some more of our Cinchies. Congratulations on everything you've accomplished so far.
Thank you, Deirdre.
You know, we saw you there in your living room, and eventually, you know, your family's going to want their living room back.
Yes.
How do you, as a mompreneur, how do you know when it's time to kind of hand over the hands-on part of it to somebody else? Like, how do you gauge financially when it's time to start going bigger?
Well, when you get more funding, that's when it's time to move on to somebody else. Right now, we've been able to handle it within our budget right now.
So you've been doing what we thought was pretty interesting by handing out the free samples, mm-hmm. like if you're in the grocery store or something, and people are, you know, then sending it in. And that seems like that's been pretty successful.
Oh, it's been incredibly successful. I know, like as a mother, if I got a sample and I tried something and I really liked it, I would tell all my friends. And actually, to give out the samples was actually more affordable than going to a PR marketing firm. Because of the free sample program that I've been offering, we've been able to get into a lot of local parenting magazines all across the country.
And kind of getting the word out, letting people know about it. Is that one of the things about like bringing a new product out, is that you've just got to really think out of the box, literally, to try to figure out a way to let people know about it?
Yeah, because of a tight budget. We have to be very creative in how we get the word out there.
One of the ways you do that is by brainstorming and networking with people in your community who are doing similar things, and you've helped form a group called the Parent Innovators Group, and you have a new website, parentinnovators.com. We'll have a link on KCRA.com, but this is basically one-stop shopping. If you're somebody in this area who feels really inspired by things like this or some of the other stories you've seen this week, to try to network with some people who are doing the similar kinds of things.
Right, and one of the things was when I first started out, I was very isolated in my house for hours and hours at a time, and I thought, wow, it'd be a great idea to get a lot of mothers of like mind around me and become my support group. So we email each other, we talk to each other, we share ideas. There are people that have gone on even further. They're already manufacturing in China, and they already have distributors across the world. And then there's some people that have started our group who are just starting and just have an idea and don't know how to get started. So we'll help you get that idea going.
By sharing the information with each other.
Yes, most definitely.
So another way you're trying to get the word out is in a kind of, I think, kind of interesting way. You're actually auditioning for a reality show this weekend.
Yes, I'm auditioning for Everyday Edisons.
And basically, this is a show that takes entrepreneurs around the country and then helps them market and launch their products. On PBS?
Yes, it's on PBS, yeah.
Great. Mm-hmm. And they are actually going to be joining us tomorrow to show us some of the products that they chose last year and what's happened with them since there. So good luck to you.
Well, thank you very much.
And what's next with Cinchies? We have a very thin producer who's wondering if you'll have an adult version anytime soon.
And it's so funny that you should say that, because a lot of requests that we get are actually for grown-ups as well, too.
So, sounds like yes?
Oh, yes.
Yeah?
Line extensions, of course.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, thank you, Eva. Continued good luck. And if
thank you
would like to see Eva's story again, please check out our new webpage, kcra.com/morningnews. You'll see all of our mompreneurs there, and you also have a link to Eva's Parent Innovators website as well.